Greetings, I'm Demonac, and it's arena time. So let's recap. I curb stomp my opponent in the first game. Then I lose the game. I'm gonna blame it on the 1-in-4 chance that I lost the game. Because any of the other three outcomes, it would have probably been a close game, or in fact, one of those outcomes, I would have probably stomped him if it turned Mike Scarab into a 5-5. But okay, so I lose that game. That was randomness. It happens. Then I run into the guy who has the absolute perfect bolster warrior start. And there's no way I can remotely defend against that. The only chance I had was to draw the Aconite Soul Priest to 4 damage everything. This is not good. This should be good, but everything feels crappy now because that last game was so bullshit. I really would like to know how many copies of those cards that warrior had, because that seems like an incredibly, like, unlikely ridiculous start, but maybe he just had an unlikely draft where it gave him everything he goddamn needed. We're just going to play the Unstable Ghoul, because... He doesn't completely win against that thing. No, okay, we're gonna scare him first. Wow, is this not the time to know which of these is the thing I need? The Big Game Hunter is the most powerful, but the Wolf Rider is much more likely to be good in the short term. I'm gonna take the Wolf Rider, because I don't feel that great about my ability to live to the long term anymore. I do have a Big Game Hunter. But, yeah. What to do about this?
What to do?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Another night on the prowl.
Okay, that's not great. Left my guy alive. Interesting. So... Dark Cultist. I can't make the Dark Cultist work right. It's not worth using him, obviously. The Unstable Ghoul is not bad, though. We're obviously going to do that. So the Unstable Ghoul should take out the frog one way or another. Yeah. Ow. That's interesting. I wish I had another taunt. But I don't. Although, I could send in the Wolf Rider, kill that, and it would kill both of them. And since I can't do anything else good this turn, you know what? That's what I'm going to do. I'm back to just, like, what's the annoying play? That's the annoying play, because now he feels like he killed his own guy. It's not true. Like, I spent my whole turn and a valuable, like, surprise attack card to kill that, which was not really that much stuff. It's probably not worth it, but... Yeah. Seemed good at the time. I would love if he had nothing good to do with this turn, but it seems unlikely. He's probably choosing. Actually, if he had nothing good to do with this turn, it would probably mean his hand's full of big, expensive things to compete with mine, so I probably wouldn't be much better off. That's okay, though, because against that guy, I can actually play Anubisath, and it has some chance of succeeding. Not a great chance. He just needs one or two more damage to take it out, and it's obviously a high priority to take it out so it doesn't buff someone, but... Oh, not taking it out. Oh, interesting. So, let's see. It's not a great situation. I wouldn't be getting another guy out if I just hit that for 4 and then Holy Nova, which would weaken that, heal me, and heal this guy back up mostly. He'd still have the 1-2 taunt. It'd be nice if I could hold off on that. Now, I could hit that, play the Soul Priest, and then finish it off with her. I need her to die before I get Holy Nova again. This guy'd be at 1 hit point, but if he dies, he'd give +3/+3 to the Soul Priest, which could go either way, actually. It could screw me, potentially, but... I could also just put out lots of guys. I don't know what's going on. I'm gonna take not a ridiculous amount of damage. I'm just going to put out lots of guys. I don't know how that goes as far as moves are, but my opponent is just trying to burn me down. That is a bad sign. Oh, really? Interesting. I think I can work with this. Do one damage, four damage, one damage, Holy Nova. Then he can fit. Yeah, I can take out the entire opposing force with the Holy Nova if he doesn't do anything else. I wonder. Now I have to remember what I did in my head because I was screwed up in the implementation phase.
Time waits for no one.
Trying to decide what to... You already hit me. Just went directly for my face. I'm questioning that decision, but we'll see. Maybe he has a lot of damage in his hand or something, but... I think he underestimates my power. That's currently what it looks like. Oh my god, I'm going to draw a billion cards. Proposal accepted.
Is someone injured?
I'm not counting on the +3/+3 to be on anything. It actually probably would be better, but... Okay, so we're going to kill this, obviously. That's going to die from Holy Nova. Hit him. Okay, well, I was going to kill it with her, but maybe I should keep her alive then.
My fate is sealed.
Either way, it's going to get some healing. Holy Nova. Smash. Board control. And, like, not just a little. Like, this is serious. Would you like to surrender now? It's pretty early in the game for surrender time. He probably has some big minions. So. I'm not saying he should. But I wouldn't be that surprised, because that was a really obnoxious turn from his point of view. He thought he had lots of stuff and was going to beat me down. Now he's looking at a lot of enemies. I really do have, like, no mechs in here for him to buff, do I? Hardly any, certainly. More taunt. Hey, this guy really likes his taunt. Interesting. So, let's really take them down. So if I heal her up to 7, then hit that, she'll barely be alive. They go bop and pop. Or actually, you bop with her so I keep this alive. Why not? I'm probably going to do this then. See what card I get. I don't think it would change anything, but you never know. Get another Holy Nova. Well, it's chosen. That's pretty spiffy. Yeah, okay.
Let the dark in.
Hey, I'm gonna do that.
My fate is sealed.
Right away.
My fate is sealed.
Right away.
Probably a mistake. I'm probably gonna get hit with the Starfall. Frankly, anything killing her at this point would be unfortunate. But I can Velen's Chosen my priest or something. I don't know.
Your magic shall not save me.
So nothing him, and then... Wait, so you have an eerie statue and a silence, and you silence him. Boy, you are obviously in a bad situation. It's about to get a lot worse. Oh, I can't play this and the ghoul and Holy Nova. But I want the 3-point Holy Nova. Am I going to draw too many cards? Probably. Yeah, I'll live. Do I take him out? No, he's never... Well, my opponent's demonstrated the ability to silence him. There's no way he's going to get enough damage out of it, though. I'm just going to ignore it. Oh, yeah, I already had the plus one spell damage. Whoops, I didn't actually need that. I should have played the ghoul instead. Oh, well.
Must consider.
Yeah, I don't want to draw more cards. So, yes, it's possible my opponent could silence that thing and get to attack with a 7-3 once. I don't think I care. Desperately digging for cards, but it's a bit late now. There's nothing you could do for 4 mana that would save you, I don't think. Yeah. You're already dead by the math. I don't have to do anything.
Let the dark in.
My fate is sealed.
Let's look back. The Sek has had 2 just brutally easy wins. And 2 pretty rough losses, one of which was actually insane. Like, I don't think there's anything I could have done against that warrior. But, like, jeez. Well, again, I had the healing Nova in my hand or whatever. I could have drawn the Akhenai Soul Priest and blown most or all of them up at one point. But it was...
Light smiles.
That would have been a real Hail Mary. This is bad. Go away, all of you. Give me some of my 2 and 3 cost minions, of which there are like a dozen. Ugh. She's great and all, but I am concerned. She doesn't do any damage. If I don't draw any other like minions to go with her, it's not going to work out well. That's not what I had in mind. I'm going to coin him out first.
That might feel a little tingly.
I don't want him turning her into another one-cost minion, especially if I buffed her. With him out, I have more options, because I could, like, Power Word Shield him and actually defeat some kind of minion. But yeah, he's a cool guy and all, but I have to play him first before her in this situation. Drugs are pretty stupid. Although, my guy will barely kill it if I do the Power Word Shield. Because it'll get +1/+1. Oh well, that's how we're going to do it.
Is someone injured?
If he lives somehow, I can heal him.
Time for a chill.
Probably dead, though. Then again, if my opponent had a way to kill him, would he not have killed him? Like, just like Holy Smite him or something? I don't know. It would be kind of weird if he played his Trog and then was saving the Holy Smite for now, but probably has more minions than he has Holy Smites, so keeping it would give more flexibility. It's just like, it's a risk to leave the enemy minion alive where it could have been buffed or something. Like that. I don't know. I've got 2 losses already. This is very frustrating. I've been having such a hard time getting any good runs. God damn it, that's not good either. Because he totally beats this guy. It's not like I got a silence. I can't even heal my guy to draw a card and still play the Micro Machine, so that's poor. I'm actually in a bad place now. Awesome. Given it won't survive that, I should maybe... If I don't heal him, I won't be able to heal him enough to survive this guy anyway, though. The cards would be really good. I'd love to have more guys I can play. Like, this guy at 2 attack is not going to be great. Like, if my opponent just kills him, I won't be able to heal this guy big enough to finish off the Disciple without... Yeah. If I killed his disciple now, I'd lose my entire army. Like, I would get rid of it and he wouldn't get his power, but I'd lose my entire army. So healing my guy to draw the card and doing that would be dumb. Now, losing my entire army to do that and then getting out the micro machine, that might be what I have to do. As much as I'd like to draw the cards, I think I'm going to do badly in this tactical situation. I think I'm actually better off suiciding my guys. Right away. Not a big fan of that move. I'm sure you're not, but it wasn't going to work out. On the plus side, this will be big enough to kill that by the time he gets out. Oh, that is a good draw. Because this guy counters that super hard. And now he's got the micro machine to actually protect. Exactly as planned. So, yeah. That's got to be a little frustrating for my opponent. Unless he has a way to buff this guy. Or silence or something.
I must consider.
But it'd be really weird if a runaway micro machine won the whole game. Can happen. Pretty uncommon. Uh-oh.
Welcome to the exhibit.
Okay. I was worried about something worse than that happening. But, yeah. This is okay. I can actually buff the micro machine with this guy. I have so few other targets for that. I can't do this yet. It takes 7 mana. So I could kill one of his guys and then heal this guy, but I couldn't heal him enough. He's going to get taken out by the curator. So the curator was a good play there. I think we're just going to go... If I played this guy, it would really protect the micro machine. Because if he just kills it with the curator, then he's going to be able to take out the micro machine with that guy. But I would do a bunch of damage. That's actually... Yeah, I should hold off on this. Having the extra like taunt out there protecting this guy might just win me the game. So we're going to do that. We're going to kill that because it... Unlike the Shredder, it's not giving my opponent more on the board. Do that to protect and continue the beatings. Keep growing that 2 attack per turn. Till my opponent Holy Novas or something. But because yeah, he had a pretty good play there. Because I could take out either of his guys with this, and then the curator could finish him, and the curator's giving you great value. If the 1-2 does anything for you, you've gotten good value out of the card. Often the 1-2 does nothing for you, and you still get okay value out of the card. Because it does let you choose, if you're lucky, you get to choose whether you need a small or a large minion at the time. If you're unlucky, it'll give you 3 things that are too similar and probably doesn't help, but... Ah, crap. I mean, it still gets in the way. I'm still going to get more hits with the micro machine, but that's not quite what I was hoping. If I Holy Nova that, whatever comes out is still going to thwart me, so that's a sucker move. That's not actually going to work. So, no, we're just going to go... this won't make him big enough to survive, so I'm going to play this because he uses all my mana. And continue crushing. I have 2 big Wrecking Balls out there. He can easily kill one. But then what? Yeah. I have not had a lot of games where an out-of-control micro machine has done this well for me. Like, yeah, he healed a bunch from this. Like, that was pretty unpleasant, but... Micro machine has still done all 10 of that damage. And we're still even in cards. And he's going to have a random 2-cost minion against my 6-cost minion. Consider. Okay, that sucks. Hey, that sucks too.
Is someone injured?
Wow. Okay, that was a very unpleasant turn. Not gonna lie. Okay, I have to Holy Nova because of that guy. It's just too much BS. Is it more important to kill... Like, I can't even kill all of these... I want all of these things to die.
I must consider...
Since he's going to get healed, it seems to make more sense to kill him. This is the toughest one. This is really bad, though. This is really bad. I really want it dead. He's going to draw a bunch of cards from it, which is incredibly horrible. But I think I will control the minion wars best if I kill this guy. At least my opponent will have, like, obnoxious stuff, but he won't have any attack ability on the board. This guy should just be able to just keep killing things with any luck. Oh, that's right. He even draws a card for me healing. Awesome. Damn it! I would have liked that to heal my opponent so he wasn't getting a free card out of it. It was really... That was a very good turn for him, a very bad turn for me, even though my army looks bigger. He drew so many cards. But I had to kill the assassin, obviously. He's got that. Does he have a Shadow Word Death? Because that would be bad. He's still trying to draw it. He probably has a Shadow Word Death in there that he's trying to draw. Acid Ooze. Okay. Okay. And another Holy Nova. It's the priest that really needs to die. I think I can live with the other stuff, honestly.
Me smash.
Well, the ooze will kill him, though. That doesn't actually work as I want. I just don't feel like it's worth Holy Nova-ing as long as I've got her dead. So I can do that. If I play both of these guys, I have a lot of stuff, but then I'm not healing him. He's only one damage away from being smoten.
Me smash.
Yeah, I'm just going to play the Army of Doom here. It's probably a bad idea because my opponent got so many cards ahead. But... I don't think that using I was basically using the Holy Nova just to kill this, which would have been silly. It would kill that and would have given me a lot more health on my ogre, which is good, but now we'll see what I can do. So I could hit that guy, that would give some health to one of these. Like losing this guy to reduce him to one health. Then the Holy Nova will finish him, kill that. Then one of the other guys can kill the healing fountain. I should be able to wipe out the whole army, I would think. Although I could Mukla's champion, then this guy could kill that and live, but I'm not going to Holy Nova then. It's going to be hard to take them all out. He could kill her and live. And then, no, I like the Holy Nova plan better at this stage. So,
my fate is sealed.
Oh yeah, I have to do that first. Damn it. I'm going to take the damage on my guys first, but okay. Not sure that my ogre needs full 10 health, but having another guy out for Mukla seems like a good plan. Okay, now what?
You have been.
Okay. I was really still genuinely worried. I felt like he was digging for a Shadow Word Death, which meant that any turn he could have drawn it, but also he could have had like a mind control that he just hadn't gotten around to, or who knows what. Okay, so we managed to get back up to even... But that seems like crap, because I'm pretty sure this should have been a good deck. It's just I'm so far behind, I'm going to have to fight for every goddamn win next time. If you like this, please click the eponymous button. And don't forget to subscribe to Demonette Games for more Hearthstone Arena and other gaming videos.